and welcome to this painting video. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint the Blitz Bowl box set up to battle ready. Now, before we begin, we need to give our models here an undercoat, and as you can see, I've used Wraithbone and Mechanicus Standard Grey. We'll be starting off by painting the Reichland Reavers player, and for this we'll be using Calidor Sky for the blue details, Uthran Grey for the light grey details, Mephiston Red for the red details, Steel Legion Drab for the brown details, Lead Belcher for the silver details, and Retributor Armour for the gold details. So, we're going to dip into our pot of Calidor Sky, and then what we're going to do is just thin it on our palette slightly, and get our brush to a good point, and now we can start applying it to the model. And for this, we're just going to put it on all of the armour panels, so that includes like the chest plate, the big shoulders, and the elbow pads and knee pads as well. Next, we're going to move on to Uthran Grey, and for this, we're going to put it on the stripe of the helmet and any wrappings around arms and legs. Because this is a light colour, you might need a couple of coats of it. Next, we're going to apply Mephiston Red. We're going to put them on the shoes and any gloves the players have. Next, we're going to use Steel Legion Drab. And we're going to put this on any of the leather strappings on the model. You can also use this for the knee pad holder as well on his legs. With that dry, we're going to move on to Lead Belcher, and we're going to apply this on any face grills or any weaponry. And finally, we're going to use Retributor Armour, and for this we're going to put it on the crest of the helmet and the little wings and his belt buckle. This can be a little bit fiddly, so don't worry, just take your time, and if you do smudge the paint onto any of the places, you can always tidy up with the colours we used beforehand. Now that our base coats are dry, we can move on to our shades and contrasts. For this, we'll be using Seraphim Sepia for the uniform cloth, then Drakonoff Nightshade for the blue armour, then Nuln Oil for the rest of the uniform, and Gilliman Flesh for the skin. So, we're going to dip into our pot of Seraphim Sepia here. I'm not going to thin it down, so I'm just going to take it straight out of the pot onto the brush. And now we can paint it onto our model. And for this, we're just going to get it on the uniform cloth that we've not painted on yet. We want to make sure we don't get it on anywhere else, but don't worry, let it dry, and then you can always paint over with the base coats we had earlier. You can always add more to the recesses if you want it to be a little bit darker. Next, we're going to use Drakonhof Nightshade, and we're going to put that all over the blue armour. With our blue dry, we're now going to move on to the Nuln Oil, and we're going to apply that onto the other areas, such as the silver, the red, the Steel Legion Drab, and the gold. And now we're going to finish off with the skin, and for this we're going to use Gilliman Flesh. I'm going to apply it all over the arms, and you might find on other players that there will be bare heads and legs as well. If you find that you've got too much of the contrast on the model, don't worry, you can always take a clean brush and soak it up. With our Reichland Reaver player now finished, we can move on to our Skaven Blight Scramblers player. And for this we'll be using Mournfine Brown for the fur, Corvus Black for the black details, Steel Legion Drab for the brown details, and Mephiston Red for the red details. So, I'm going to dip into our pot here, and we're going to get it out onto our palette. I'm going to thin it down with just a touch of water, and then we can start applying it to our model. So, we're going to pop it onto the fur, onto the arms, but not all the way up, because that's going to be some skin later. And we've got some little fur patches around the face as well. Just make sure you get that one just tucked under the armour. Now we're going to apply our Corvus Black, and we're going to put this onto the little cloth areas, especially like this skirt. Make sure you get the underside of the model there as well, just so it's nice and dark and looks moody. Next we're going to move on to Steel Legion Drab, and for this we're going to use it for any leather work, such as the belt, wrappings, and he's also got a little pouch under his left arm. With that dry, now we can use the Mephiston Red and we're going to put this on the gloves. With those first base coats done, now we can move on to our last ones. And for this, I'll be using Lead Belcher for the silver details, Moot Green for the green details, and Wraithbone for the skin. So we're going to dip into a pot of Lead Belcher, just like we did with the other colours. Pop on our palette, just give it a touch of water, and then we can start popping it onto the metal panels. And for this, we're going to just go around the edges for the pauldrons, and you can go onto the chainmail and the helmet as well. And don't forget the punching dagger in his hand. Now we're going to apply Moot Green into any of the recesses on the symbol and the shoulder pad. This paint's a little bit thin, so you might need a couple of coats just to build it up. And finally, we're going to use our Wraithbone just to pick out the skin and the tail. You can also use it on the teeth and any claws as well. With our base coats now dry, we can move on to our contrasts and our shades. We'll be starting off with Garrigax Sewer Thin Downward Contrast Medium for the metalwork, Gillenman Flesh for the skin and the tail, then Baletan Green for the details, and Nuln Oil for all the other details. So we're going to take two parts contrast medium and pop them onto our palette. And that's two. Then we'll wash and dry our brush. And then I'm going to take one part Garrigax Sewer and we're going to just mix that in. So we still want quite a nice dark colour, but we don't want too much on our brush. Now we can start popping it onto our metalwork. So I want to apply it all over the metalwork, but we just want to be careful that we don't get it onto anywhere else that's painted. But don't worry if you do, you can always tidy it with the layer paints and the base coats we used earlier. Next, we're going to apply our Gillenman Flesh all over the skin and the tail. If it starts to pull too heavily towards the base of the tail, you can take a clean brush and soak it up. And now we're going to use Baletan Green, just in the green recesses of the armour and the icons. And finally, we're going to use Nuln Oil for all the other details, such as the brown, the red, and the black. With our shades and contrast now dry, we can move on to the basing. And for this, we'll be using a Grelin Badland for both of them and using our trusty texture tool for this. So we're going to dip into our pot with the wide end. I'm going to just hold on to the pot as well so we're stable. And we're going to scoop a small amount off, make sure it doesn't drip anywhere. And then we can pop it onto our base. So with this, we're going to try and get it around the feet. So I'm just going to push it down onto the base. And we want to avoid the little hole that's in the center there. That's where the ball goes in. And we can use the other end, which is the smaller end, just to push it around. Texture paints take roughly about an hour to dry. With the texture now dry and the rim of the base is painted, our human and Skaven players are now complete. And there you have it, ready to smash skulls on the pitch, our Reichland Reaver lineman and our Skaven Blight Scramble Line Rat are prepared to go head to head. By following these methods and techniques, you can easily apply these to any players in your team. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and we hope you enjoy painting your own Blitz Bowl box set, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye!